Man, it is too fucking early for all this shit. What's going on, everybody? It is your boy Crypto, and welcome back to another video. And today, we're gonna let that sit so it doesn't spill over. We are reacting to another Eminem diss by Nick Cannon. Mr. Grumlot, Mr. Gigolo, with a bada boo, every daddy boo, da bada boo, da bada boo. Now, props to Nick Cannon for stepping on the throat and staying on the gas for what he wants, okay? Obviously, he wants Eminem to come on Wildin' Out, and he said that he's gonna respond back to back until Eminem responds, and that's on the family. When something's on the family, you gonna do it. So this dropped about 30 minutes ago. You know, I'm just sitting butt-ass naked in the living room eating a bag of Cheetos, and then I get some Instagram DM saying that Nick Cannon has responded again. But this time, no Suge Knight. He didn't bring in just Hitman, Holla, or Charlie Clips, or whatever the Easy's guy's name is. He brought the whole fucking Black Squad on this. So I have a feeling maybe DC Young Fly is gonna come in here. We're gonna see Conceited. Yo, DJ D-Rick, cut the beat! I hope they bring in the one guy that has Asperger's. I don't even know if he's on the show anymore, but that would be so funny to hear him come in on this. I tweeted yesterday that I kind of feel like Eminem and Nick Cannon are organizing all this, that they squashed all the beef, and that this is just an epic big promotion for the craziest episode of Wildin' Out ever. And honestly, I would be cool with that. It was already gonna be the biggest episode ever, but when you're building it up like this, it's cool marketing. I like it. Obviously, this song was made in advance because they told Eminem they were gonna go back to back, so it's not like they made this diss, waited for a response, and said, fuck it, let's get in the booth and do it again. Obviously, both of these were pre-made. They might even have a third one made. You're not getting past me, okay? It's very clear what you guys are trying to do. You're trying to get Eminem on Wildin' Out, and I'm here for it. I would say I hope Nick Cannon learned from the feedback from the first one, but since they already made this, I don't know. I hope it's a different format and it's not loaded with hooks like the last one. But I'm gonna skew the audio on this just a little bit because my video was claimed yesterday because I didn't realize that Nick Cannon was part of a record label. My man has 50,000 less monthly listeners than I do, but I digress. So without further ado, guys, go ahead and pop a do, and let's get right on in to this shitty fucking review. It might not be shitty. It might be kind of good this time. All right, let's see what you're working with, Black Squad. Don't disappoint me here.
Still waiting. Now we gotta pray for him.
It's incredible. All right.
Lord forgive us, I know that it's kinda wrong for five brothers this talented to be on one song. But that white boy, he is nice. But he crossed the black man, Lord Jesus Christ.
We gon' pray for him. I see that.
Move Haley out the way when we spray cans. We don't shoot kids and women, we shootin' amen. Look, that double entendre, kinda heavily. Damn, and what you like 5 minutes away from 70? Oh.
Man, why does everybody always bring up the old shit? Like, I don't understand. I hated when Eminem did it in his diss tracks. I hated when MGK did it. I hate when everyone does it. It's stupid. Like, we all get old. Like, how was that a diss? But irregardless of that, there were some cool little flips right there. He said, move Haley out the way. We are not shooting women and kids. We shooting amen. And, it's a double entendre with amen. Then he said, pray for the white boy because he just crossed a black man like Jesus Christ. Because a lot of people think that Jesus Christ was black and Jesus Christ up on the cross and stuff like that. And then we said, we got to pray for him and stuff. So there's a lot of different entendres with the word pray and, like, religion right there. So it's a cool little flips that he's got going on right there. But the old age stuff, man, I can never give that points in anybody's diss.
What you like 5 minutes away from 70? Oh, I meant 47. Send him to hell if he bore to heaven. Strapping the dynamite word to Florida heavens. I get the grip in the Glock. He better call a reverend. Give Eminem fours and knock him out of Jordan 7. Oh, you got
your own sneakers. That was nice. Okay.
Well, to let you know them Wildin' Out Jordans is on the way. Nah, I ain't do this first for the fame and the clout. I did this first to say, keep my brother name out your mouth.
I mean, this joint is bullying, cause I know he ain't gonna clap back. So I don't be dealing with these rap cats. I'm the best and that's that. Put that on everything in my cash app. A bunch of red rags and black lacks. Incredible. They catch me with this, I'm going federal. I've been a star. Your favorite actress wanna get sexual. You been afraid, M. This ain't that renegade, M. When you ain't perked up, you sweeter than lemonade, M. Black Squad, you gonna link with them. See, you tried to bully Pink and them, Britney Spears and NSYNC and them, and got the beefing with Ja Rule with the cops behind you. And every show since 04, you had the slot behind you.
Okay, so it kind of going out, like, Eminem has gone at people in the past, but he's typically gone at people that can't really do anything, like he went at Britney Spears, Christina Aguilera, NSYNC, like all those beefs back in the day. And the one time he went at somebody that was like kind of dangerous was Ja Rule, and they said that he went at him with the cops behind him, and now every show he's got the SWAT team behind him. It is what it is, man. I mean, notoriously back in the day, he did go at people that were like, it was just more like people that he just didn't fucking like. I mean, he went at Limp Bizkit, which is like a heavy metal rap band, so it's a little dangerous right there. Went at Ray Benzino, who fucking kills people, so that was a little scary. I don't know, I can give you points for that one. I can give you some points for that one. But he's saying when he's not perked up, he's sweeter than lemonade, and talking about his drug use, perked up, like, and happy. You know, it's nice. It's nice. Okay.
the show since 04, you had the SWAT behind you. Man, y'all are find an all-time great in a small town lake. I hawk them down with the cage. Don't you got a cash flow? What the fuck you mad for? Subtract you at a casket? That's the aftermath. Ho hopper.
Hi, Slim, let's kill it with all the chit-chat. Eminem, but you get the sticks. Now that's a Kit Kat. So wait, damn it, you mad that you ain't canning. All them pills you stay cramming, still giving you brain damage.
I can't recognize conceited on a beat. I just physically can't do it. Let me rewind this so I can get this. I was too surprised to hear conceited on a beat.
Hi, Slim, let's kill it with all the chit-chat. Eminem, but you get the sticks, now that's a Kit Kat. So
okay.
Wait, damn it, you mad that you ain't canning. All them pills you stay cramming, still giving you brain damage.
Okay, so one thing, these guys keep going at each other, and I can clearly see this is all a ploy now. Like, it was interesting at first, but now it's very clear that they just trying to get this motherfucker on Wild and Out. Like, none of these guys have problems with him. They're saying, like, they're mad he's not canning. I don't think there's, like, 95% of the world that would be okay with not being Nick Cannon, and I'm very certain that Eminem is okay with not being Nick Cannon, okay? So, but like I said, it's kind of confirmed in my brain now that they squashed the beef and that this is all for promotion for a Wild N Out episode, because, like, this feels too orchestrated for me now. It doesn't feel legit anymore.
Cannon, all them pills you stay cramming, still giving you brain damage. Your guilty conscience told you was the man and all, but now you just a circus act because you stay up on cannonballs.
Okay, so that was a dirty fucking line right there. He said his guilty conscience told him he's the man and all. Eminem has a song called Guilty Conscience where he's, like, speaking to himself and, like, the demonic version of himself, the devilish version of himself. And then he said, you're like a circus act because you stay on Cannon's balls, and Nick Cannon, you know, Cannon balls. Okay, I've expected this kind of stuff because I've heard similar punchlines on Wild N Out, like the Kit Kat bar and, like, the Cannon balls and, like, twin cannons, like Nick's babies. Like, I've heard stuff like that. That actually wasn't even in this one, but, like, I know that line from Wild N Out. But anyway.
Your guilty conscience told you was the man and all, but now you just a circus act cause you stay up on cannonballs. You always hide in your trailer, we know you big mad. Get your bitch to run in our lap like this is gym class. Cause all my niggas just stand up like Sinbad. Big mag in the cans that get rid of Slim fast. Instead of staying in the booth to get your rhyming out, it's season 15, here's your invite to Wildin' Out.
Ain't no back doing cause all of my troops thorough. Ain't got no bitch, Glock Nina, my new girl.
Is that DC?
All my homies keep dying, my puke Earl. God should've took him and just let us keep Juice World. Look.
This whole thing's done with now. Like, I don't even want to listen to the rest of this anymore. Like, you're gonna do that, man? I'm not cool with that. I mean, there's all affair and love and battle rap and stuff, but, like, the man fucking died 2 days ago, man. Come on, you can't be doing that kind of shit. That's fucked up.
Glock Nina, my new girl. I'm sick of all my homies keep dying. My puke Earl. God should've took him and just let us keep Juice World. Look, Nick, my brother, you dissed him that gotta suffer. I told him, don't diss you back. Let us handle this motherfucker. Look, I scratched the cereal number up off the baby llama. M ain't seen the ratchet this dirty since his baby mama.
So that was kind of cool right there. But, like, I'm a little fucked up over that Juice World line. I'm not even gonna lie.
God damn. Y'all niggas ain't have to do it like that.
My man Nick's gonna come on and big up his squad. This is getting fucked up games. It's getting corny as shit for me now, man.
All this cocaine out here, and you wanna put your nose in my business. Told you. I ain't have to rap on this motherfucker.
Thank God.
I'm not gonna rap.
Good.
Do what you did.
Just do what you did.
You used to be in a position to talk to kids and they listen. Now you a politician. You voted for Trump, bitch, admit it. They used to call you a menace in the shoe fit you wore. But now you getting facelifts like an Instagram whore. Used to be the king of the rule, ludicrous, lucrative lyrics. Now all you do is just cry like you got Tourette's in the stairs.
What is Nick doing, man? Like, does he not listen to his stuff before he puts it out? Like, does he not hear how he sounds? Like, I can literally see Nick Cannon with a piece of paper, like, doing this. Like, you used to be the man, they used to call you a menace. Now you just a bitch, you voted for Trump, just admit it. Like, I can literally see him just, like, looking at his phone, and he sounds like he's, like, you used to be the man, just a minute. Like, it doesn't even sound good. does Nick listen to his stuff before he puts it out there? Like, I've heard him rap on Wild N Out, and he's not bad. Like, I've heard him rap before and he's not bad. Is he doing this on purpose? Is he not a studio rapper? Like, I don't understand what's going on.
Minutes in the shoe fit you wore, but now you getting facelifts like an Instagram whore. Used to be the king of the rule, ludicrous, lucrative lyrics. Now all you do is just cry like
like you got Tourette's in the stare. Maybe it's your mommy issue, maybe your white devilish spirit. Maybe your original music that your fans used to cherish. Now you debated, disputed, hated, and viewed an American as a motherfucking drug addict. Never be a legend. And you really should start to stare at who's in the mirror. Look at all that fucking Botox, bitch. I know you embarrassed.
Okay, so he's talking about, I don't know why he's talking about he's a drug addict and stuff. He's been like 11 years sober. Shit's weird. This whole thing, like I said, it's just turned corny for me now. I don't even like this anymore. It was cool at first. Now it's just weird.
Man, look at all that fucking Botox. Bitch, I know you embarrassed. Fuck all the tricks and the gimmicks. You like the new white supremacists. Say the same fucking sentences, nigga. You ain't no lyricist.
Ram.
I bet you never thought the kill shot would come from the cannon.
Alright, cool. Never thought you
used to be a renegade.
I had no idea that Nick Cannon was gonna start wilding out on me.
Good God, man. What's the like to dislike ratio on this, man? It's better than the last one. So it really wasn't that bad. I was kind of feeling it to start off with. Then it got a little fucked up with the Juice WRLD stuff. And then Nick Cannon decided he felt like he should rap again. And that just like kind of fucked it up for me. Not even gonna lie. I don't know. It feels like it's all been orchestrated now. It doesn't feel legit to me anymore. And I'm not having fun with the situation anymore. It was fun yesterday. But now, like, this is just, it's getting stupid. I don't know. Let me know what you guys thought in the comments down below. Nick Cannon should never rap again. And until next time, guys, it has been your boy, Crypt, and I am signing out. Blah!